The sanctuary is quiet, save for distant scratching sounds. The smell of blood hangs thick. Something awful has happened here. In the western cells, blood and bodies are everywhere, as are webs. Perhaps spiders are responsible for the slaughter. Rows of cells lie ahead. You should look in them for signs of Marguerite. The markings on this lever indicate the rattle of a portcullis echoes up the passage behind you. This door is both locked and barred from the inside. It doesn't look like you can get through. Best to search elsewhere. There is more bloodshed in the north wing, along with something else, the faint tang of decay in the air. Thank you. The stench of corruption grows stronger. Maybe the spiders didn't kill these people after all. Maybe it was something else. Archbishop Dryden waits to speak with you at the top of his dais. The moans of the undead rumble throughout the sanctuary. Their numbers must be growing. The scrape of bone against stone sounds from the north wing. Something strange ahead. The bloodstains on the floor seem to go through the wall on the right. You have found a secret room. This must be where the warden kept his keys. His body lies on the floor, twisted in death.
Thank you.
The stench of walking corpses hangs thick in the air here. The undead have battered these doors relentlessly. You might be able to open them now with the master key. This way lies Minnan's ward. The reek of the undead is almost palpable.
Thank you.
farther down the passage, you hear the faint sounds of someone breathing. A survivor. A dirtcake man stares at you from across the room, his eyes glazed with madness. Fitzwood vanishes before your eyes. The exit gate slams closed as you approach. From the south, you hear another portcullis clatter open. The south wing. This way, you hear the rattle of iron, the low metallic growling. This lever may open the way out. The exit gate grinds upward, but several nearby doors open as well. You hear clattering and growling from within. Archbishop Dryden waits to speak with you at the top of his dais. You hear thumps and groans among the shells of the archives. The undead have overrun this place. A faint breeze ruffles the pages of the books. Pounces on Willem and tears out his throat. Drenched with his blood, it turns to snarl at you. Whispers. The void consumes the flame. The flame consumes the nothingness. The path lies between. duality has returned. Doom shall darken the flame. This room is a bloodbath. Many bodies and bones lie scattered about, torn and gnawed by sharp teeth. In the distance, someone's cry for help is choked off by a gurgling scream. Wet sounds of tearing flesh follow. You have slain the library's unwanted guests. You hear a terrible rending, gobbling sound from the room ahead, and suddenly it stops. A trail of blood drops leads to this section of shelves and stops. Faint voice whispers, "Let the tombs and ossuaries open. Ancient liches arise. A new order has come."
Words are scrawled in blood on the book spines here. "Help us. We cannot hold out. There are too many." The shelves seem slightly askew here.
Among the webs is a chest. Archivists kept their riches here. a chittering sound from behind the shelves here. On the pedestal, a faint voice whispers,
"And the dead shall be as the living, and the living shall weep for death."
Archbishop Dryden waits to speak with you at the top of his dais. The unearthly cries of the undead fill the tomb. The Drydens have woken from their long rest and hunger for slaughter. The sapphire gate is shut. You will have to find a way to raise it. A plaque on the floor reads, "Marn Dryden, first of the line in the reach." Hear a clatter from the hallway. The sapphire gate is open. You hear scratching sounds from the central crypt, like ragged nails against stone. Three sunstones are mounted above the gates to Gerard Dryden's tomb. The shadows within the tomb shift disturbingly. The Emerald Gate is shut. You will have to find a way to raise it. A plaque upon the floor reads, "Barry Dryden, Brother to the Flame." Hear a clatter from the hallway. The Emerald Gate is open. The scratching sound grows louder, then turns into pounding. Something trapped inside a sarcophagus wants out. A plaque upon the floor reads, "Emilian Dryden, Abbess of Great and Mistress of the Church Treasury." Thank you.
Topaz Gate is shut. You will have to find a way to raise it. A plaque upon the floor reads, "This sanctum in memory of Iso Dryden." You hear a clatter from the hallway. The Topaz Gate is raised. Hammering from Gerard's tomb grows louder and louder. It ends with the crack of splitting stone. The Amethyst Gate is shut. You will have to find a way to raise it. The flag upon the floor reads, "Charas Strike, guard captain and friend of the Holy Flame." Hear a clatter from the hallway. The Amethyst Gate is raised. From Gerard's tomb, you hear the sounds of cracking bones, gnawing teeth, and chittering laughter. Thank you.
click in the direction of Gerard's feet. Herein lies Lambert Dryden, Bishop and Defender of the Faith. Direction of Gerard's tomb. plaque upon the floor reads, Pascal Dryden, Marshal of the Militant Clergy and High Paladin of the Flame. Shriek of rusty metal, the sunstone gates enclosing Gerard's tomb grind open. A plaque on the floor reads, Gerard Dryden, the doomed bishop, may the darkness lift from thy rest. His sarcophagus shudders violently and explodes in a storm of jagged stone. Archbishop Dryden waits to speak with you at the top of his dais. Thank you. sacred aura surrounding this place puts you at ease.
Many bones are piled here, as if the
darkness suffuses the lower cathedral. The power of the duality pulses in the air. The main altar lies ahead, despoiled by evil. The stones themselves seem to sigh and moan in agony. Hear a click from the nearby portcullis. Shuddering and groaning, the bars of the winged serpent fane rise. Words are etched in the archway. Fane of the winged serpent. As the white collapses, the protective magics, the altar of the winged serpent stands before you. You will have to destroy the white guarding it before you can purify it. The shadows and corruption cloaking the altar dissipate. A sound like a soft sigh fills the chamber. You hear a click from the nearby portcullis. With a rusty shriek, the bars of the conflagration chapel rise. Word words are etched in the archway. Chapel of the Conflagration. The altar of the conflagration stands before you. You will have to destroy the White Guardian before you can purify it. As the white collapses, the protective magic surrounding the altar vanishes. It can be purified now. Words are etched in the archway. Shrine of the Avenging Maiden. Clattering like old bones, the bars of the Avenging Maiden shrine rise. The altar of the Avenging Maiden stands before you. You will have to destroy the White Guardian before you can purify it. As the white collapses, the protective magic surrounding as the darkness hanging over the altar dissolves, you hear the cries of fury from the central vault. The main altar's guardians have awakened. As the shrieks of the vanquished undead fade, A small stone tablet appears atop the main altar. It beckons you. Scratching sounds and creaking rise through the dust-choked air. Before you stands the sarcophagus of Cardinal Olag, second patriarch of Stormreach. And the cracking of stone echo up this passage. Before you stands the sarcophagus of Cardinal Yanaz, fourth patriarch of Stormreach. Hideous laughter drifts up out of the dark. Before you stands the sarcophagus of Cardinal Hengrith. As the third sarcophagus is warded, a roar of stone shakes the crypt. The floors of the tombs are disintegrating. It doesn't look like you'll be able to get up to the room above from here.
grows colder as you round the bend. Something terrible stirs ahead near the sarcophagus of Cardinal Borellis, first patriarch of Rome. As the white falls, the spell surrounding Bravonus' sarcophagus dissipates. It can now be warded. Faint, unearthly chimes seem to ring from up this passage, beckoning you to safety. The altar lies beyond the gates ahead of you. Succor is at hand. Archbishop Dryden waits to speak with you at the top of his dais.
As you shut the gate behind you, a great magical barrier rises up out of nowhere. There will be no going back. Your blood runs cold. Before you is the Wraith of Marguerite Dryden. She watches you, but does not attack. Howling in despair, Marguerite vanishes like smoke. The magical barrier at the top of the stairs vanishes. A barrier above blocks your ascent. From the side tunnel comes the rattling of dry bones. A third barrier bars your path at the top of the stairs. The groans of the living dead greet you. Another barrier, and the shrieking of ghouls on the prowl. Thank you. The stench of ghasts chokes the air here. Yet another barrier thwarts you. The last barrier to the Archbishop's chambers lies ahead. The undead here are many and ravenous. As the altar explodes in a fury of holy energy, the back wall slides open to reveal a secret passage, perhaps a way out. Archbishop Dryden stares coldly down at you from his dais. You can feel his scorn from here. Archbishop Dryden collapses unconscious. The rage of Archbishop Dryden rises from his body.